So let's go into our subject tonight. It's called The Gods of the Nations, or the Halalamad in Lashirakodash, or Islands. Now, this is based on biblical laws, statutes, and judgments of the Most High Jehovah. Immediately, God Compassion on them. These people are allowed to get you burned in the lake of fire. says here. And they have gotten them many children, and were great people, and began again to be more of the holy than the first. My sister asked me this one time. She said, how did all these people get on the earth? I said, you see what it says there, sister? How did you make a baby? You have sex. Okay? And her mind was so reprobate from living in Esau's system, she couldn't understand that the people had to have sex to repopulate the earth. This is why the Most High got the brothers teaching this knowledge, man, not brothers. But we ain't going to be defiled with you sisters. Okay? Because you're not both philosophers. And remember, y'all made that covenant in agreement with Esau, the Satan and his God. And he said, I'm going to make you a God. So until the Most High comes back here and turn that down, y'all going to be stuck in that. And we're going to learn the knowledge. And we're going to receive some of our people. While you become Jezebels and get destroyed in the lake of fire. That's what's coming on this earth. See what it says here? And began to be more like the army than the first. And now when they live so wickedly before thee, thou did them choose up to pull up from among them a man named who was Abraham. That's the genetic. But let's deal with the wicked nations, man. What did they do when they came after God? The Lord said they became prosperous through multiplication and having more honor. These areas that we're going to talk about today, those nations who came out the back, went into these specific geographical areas on this map here, mainly the areas we call Babylonia, Susa, Elam, the land of so-called Europeans called Mesopotamia, which means the land between two rivers. And if you want to find out about this, is it really real in archaeology? Get this book called The Great Cities of Ancient Mesopotamia, History of Babylon and Evil, Ur, Uruk, Metropolis, Asursa, and Ashur. And in here, you got the maps of the ancient world, the maps that go with the Bible, showing you where these people landed and went and repopulated on the earth at the time after the flood, and the things that they left on this earth that is recorded in history to show you that the Bible is not a fantasy book. It's real. This is where they landed at, this area right here. It's recorded in the Bible. It is recorded in some maps that they got from the Bible, the area that you call Mesopotamia. The nations went down in there, Elam, Kush, and our forefather Abraham from Ur, dwelling amongst these nations. Now I'm going to show you what happened when he got down in there, because there were some significant things that were going on during this time. The first recorded empire to rise up in that time was over. Let's go back to Genesis chapter 10. Let's go to Genesis 10. What did our forefathers record in this Bible to need for us to have wisdom? Geographical locations and maps. The records of the Bible are going to be shown to me so that we can shut down the opinions of evil and reprobate minded men. Genesis chapter 10 says this, in verse 6, and the sons of Ham, Cush, and Mizraim, and Put, and Canaan, these four nations became known today as the so called Africa. Cush, Ethiopia, Mizraim, Egypt, Put, the so called Libyans, and Canaan, the so called South Africans. Geographical locations located in the Bible and throughout the East. They're still over there right now. And the son of Cush was Sheba and Abelah and Shabbat and Hamath and Zabatah and the sons of Hamath, Sheba and Dedan. And Cush begot Nimrod. And he began to be a mighty hunter in the earth. He was a mighty hunter before the Lord man even saved, even as Nimrod, the mighty hunter of the Lord. And the beginning of his kingdom was Babel and Era. Can you hear me? Right over here, just like the Bible says. And the Bible right there. No geographical locations, man. None of these people came back. There's a word right down in here, right by the mouth of the Euphrates River. That's where Abraham came from, our forefather, the father of three promises, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Nowhere near the land of so-called Africa is it. According to biblical records, it came off the mouth of Ararat, which is north up here. It came down as an Asher, became the Assyrians later on. And Elam over here, who became known as the Persian Empire. The Elamites, some of them dudes are darker than us. And they have really curly hair. Because they came out as the Shemites, and they became their own nations. So when the Most High brought all these nations over the earth, people, this is where Abraham was. Let's see what was going on at that time. He said, and the scripture said, that they began to what? Become more wicked. What did they do for the prophets to leave that in the earth? Well, one of the things they did, let's go to 2 Kings 17:29. They made up their own gods. There's a problem there. Let's go to 2 Kings chapter 17 and verse 29. This one, look what they did back then. And what our forefathers left for us to understand. God, the brothers out here rocking the Bible, y'all phones, man. Let's go to 2 Kings chapter 7, verse 29. It is written. It says this. Howbeit, every nation made gods of their what? Of their own. Now, you hear that? This is recorded early from the time after the flood. They made their own what? Gods. And put them in the house of the high places of the Samaritans and made every nation and their cities where they dwelt. So back then, when you went to a city, it had a damn God. Okay. So when you went to certain cities, they made up their own gods. When you went in there, there's a rule you worship. Worship the sun god, Ra. We worship Ra. We worship Nana. Where Abraham was. That was them. So they made up their own gods. See what it says here? Nana. So it says the sun god. footsteps in the hard track in the days of the event. Just notice Acts 7:48. The warnings of the Most High to us in this time about the gods of the nation, the Anamites. And says this: Albeit the Most High dwelleth not in temples made with hands. What? Wait a minute. That's a contradiction, eh? Did our forefathers and our mothers tell us to go to church on Sunday? Did the white man teach us in his barns and in his buildings and in institutions today called seminary schools? This world is still stuck. So before you become some type of fool, like that, old brothers, you better learn these scriptures and where this stuff started from, so you can be wise and overcome these demons out here, because they're not here. And that's why you got in America, you got 15 million churches all over the place. Because it came from this corner of the earth. When you wanted to go in there superstitiously and worship these gods, now we're back there in converse. The moon God. And the people went up. You see this? They went up there to worship this thing. By his king's decree. Just like you got decrees in America from the Roman Catholic Church, the Baptist Church. You can't even teach in a so-called church to make money unless you get that mark on your face and get their codes and their handshake in iniquity. So you better watch some of these condos out here, man. Some of these camps. They don't work from keeping the Most High commandments to turn it into a denomination. And their leadership gonna be destroyed if they don't repent from that. You better watch out, man. That's what my shout shall say. Watch is what is praying. Or no nobody fools. See? You don't want the Most High's son to come down here and in the day of judgment, when this earth is all messed up, and you turn to you and say, get away from me, you work of iniquity, I don't know. You're going to be cast into the lake of fire because of your iniquity. So watch the doctrines of men, brothers, to get you destroyed. So he said that. That says the prophets. Ezekiel said it. Isaiah said it. The law says it. Moses wrote it about these gods of the nation. He said, heaven is my throne and earth is my footstool. What house will you build for me? So these houses these men built down here, starting back then, the mega church came from the Zeraths. I want y'all to go get your cameras in your townships and take photographs of Negroes mega churches. So I mean, Negro, Western, and Puerto Ricans is going in there every Sunday. And send them to the school so we can expose our people. So maybe we'll reach one of them. They're doing the same thing back then, they're doing the same thing now. Oh, you gotta have a permit to open up this building. And you can't teach hate, brother. But we're not a hate group. Y'all heard brother saying that? The Bible says, I hate abominations. So we must teach what he hates. And if you don't, you're a false prophet and a false God. So you can open up your building and get everybody else in there listening to you. See? And it says here, what house are you building for me? Said God. Well, what is the place of my rest? They damn sure ain't no damn building. Has God not made all these, has not my hand made all these things? You ask me. And he said, you stiff neck and what? Uncircumcised in heart and ears. You always resist the Holy Spirit or the Holy Ghost. As your fathers did, so do you. Listen to the Spirit, man. That's what David said in the Psalms. He said, I will hear what the Spirit says. So I like to hear what men got to say. Debating and not by
say, you stupid, the rebellious Israelites, I don't want to do this. These customs came from back then. And it's still in America right now. Oh, you got a million-man congregation. Well, they keep the commandments. They can get their wives. They coming up with the Shabbat. They preaching the gospel. They discipline. Or they following you. They following the Lord said. The Lord said, abide in me and I in you. You can do nothing without me. Check that out, St. John's. But he said, if you keep my law, my commandments, then are you my disciples indeed. Look around here and see who's keeping the commandments and who's not keeping the commandments. Then you'll know who ain't the disciple and the prophets of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shah. See what it says here? So this is what's going on out here, see? So let's go to the scriptures. First Thessalonians, chapter 4, verse 5. We stand in the Bible. They want to run their mouth? Tell them to read this. I don't care what men say. I care what God says. He's my fear and my dread. And we praise his holy name. Let's go to 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. And we're going to start at verse 5. Now, this is what Paul said about the Hananiah, the Gentiles. He said this. Not in the lust of the constituents, even as the Gentiles which know not Yahweh. Y'all hear that? When the apostles went up there on Mars Hill, they said, we explore what to do. Lost brothers in Galatia and Corinthia, like we go on to different places to preach to our lost sheep by the house of Israel. And he said, go to them and tell them in these areas in the despair that you are lost and you are forsaken the Most High, your forefathers did it. Now you've got a chance to be saved if you acknowledge, if you repent, and if you come to the straight gate and start coming here to learn. Because knowledge is power, man. Be now instructed for who? Jerusalem. Scriptures say. But learn these scriptures, man. See what it says here? The Gentiles don't know the Most High. Paul said it. It said it in Thessalonians. Why he said that? Well, I don't know. What were they carrying on him when I met him? It's going to Deuteronomy 5 and 6. It's what Yahweh told us to do. He commanded us this on Mount Sinai. He said, hey, Israel, all this foretold by say. He said this to Israel. Deuteronomy 5 and 6. And it says this. I am the Lord, thy power, Yahweh, which brought thee out of the land of Egypt. This is what he told the whole assembly. When he spake to us on our side, he said this. From the house of bondage, thou shalt have no other power before me. Adam, the Meteorite, we call the Most High Adam and the Gentile, God, Adam and Eve, power. Oh, Jordan to possess it. Did our forefathers keep the commandments in Jordan? Where's Jordan at? That's Israel. No, they did not. That's why we here in another land, church in hell. What did it say in Deuteronomy? Chapter 28, 29. And the Lord rooted them out of their land and cast them into another land as it is this day. Don't you know what that's talking about us? That's the 12 tribes in another land serving another God right now. Deuteronomy 4:26 on God. That's God. See what it says here? Deuteronomy 4:14, 1-15. Take ye therefore good heed. You know what that means? Be diligent unto yourselves. For you saw no matter of emotion of similitude in that day when the Lord Yahweh spake unto you in Horeb in the midst of the battle. Lest ye corrupt yourselves. What's wrong with the neighbor of us in the Puerto Rican today? Your ass is corrupt. And we rebuke you in the name of the Most High, Yahweh, Hashem, Yahshua, because you don't believe. Like, brother, you come here, brought out. You got to believe, man.
That's right.
Faith without works is dead, man. When we come to y'all, y'all got to believe this. Yeah. We standing there telling you what Yahweh said, and you look at it. Why you got that on your head? Why do you wear that cape? Why do you wear that turban? What's that? I'm an alien to you. If you don't understand, brother, you're going to die. We're trying to save your life from the wrath of the Lord. See what it says here? And make you a graven image, because our people are all in idolatry right now. The multitude of any figure, the likeness of a male or female, lying out into Caesar Lord, lying out into Guadalupe, lying out into crosses. A lot of you in the gods that you made up. My mother told me about this god he's having in North Carolina in the woods. I said, Mother, that was a shrine. That was a height. Yeah, but we should go back there and pray to it. I said, that's why you're in there. See? Because your parents, man, they be right, man. And if they don't get right, that's how they don't turn them for that when they get the spirit of them. See? It's up to him, not us. The likeness of any beast that is on the earth, the likeness of any winged fowl that flies in the air, the likeness of anything that creeps on the ground, the likeness of any fish that's in the water beneath the earth. Dost thou lift up thy eyes unto the heavens, and would thou see them the what? The sun. Wait a minute. The worship of the sun? No. Sunday service. Who goes to church on Sunday? Don't they go to church on Sunday? You know where that came from? Sodom. What the hell? Tell you that. Don't worship no planets. Don't get into the zodiacs. Don't get into the stars. You ain't no damn Pisces, Sagittarius, or none of that Babylonian garbage. Stop calling yourself that. And back in the old school, brothers were using the zodiac. But I told them, don't use it. Now, Jeremiah can, right? So whenever you told the brother something out of the Bible, look what happened to the elders back then. Look what happened to certain brothers. You know, you can't keep these commandments and keep dallying with witchcraft and rebellion. The Most High will judge you before you close your eyes and take your mind from you. Remember what we told you. See what it says here? And the stars and the hosts of heaven, the sun and the moon. That's exactly what they were worshiping over here in earth. That's why Abraham left that area to get the hell out of there. And what are we doing? They're called into the high calling of Ashasha to get away from our own people. What's around us? Islands, the Baptist church, the mega church, this church, that church, all the churches, Mason. Dealing with what? With witchcraft. So now we got to be on a mission
scriptures to show you about certain things about these nations and what they were dealing with. Gold, stones, going into the zodiac, going into Easter, and certain things came from the east. Here goes a picture here from a book by an archaeologist called David Ben Gurion. And on page 25, it says, right, a pillar from the 14th century Canaanite sanctuary of Hazar, the carving of hand is raised toward the crescent, suggesting worship of the moon. Now, see this? What do you think the bears can get that crescent from? You see that? They get it from moon worship. See the hands going up in the air, and you see the moon on top here? All this goes back to paganism. So you brothers as Muslims, but the Lord Most High with 50 books on his desk, and he always quote one scripture in the Bible, and he never opens up the Bible. And he says, yeah, we're the children of Israel, so what the hell are you doing on the other way? He's a diamond guy. Because he's a false prophet, man. And this is where this stuff came from. Look at this. It says, and the Canaanite religion of El, which is chiefly the deity of the bull, distant presence, who played a little part in worship. The most reverence of the gods was Baal. Hear that? Baal is Sunday worship today. Dealing with the panics, dealing with the storms, and dealing with certain months like Easter. You ever heard of Easter? Your grandmother used to roll eggs and take you out there and crack open all those yellow eggs, little pink eggs, and the blue eggs, and you used to eat them? Guess what, people? We're giving reference to this demon right here. Listen to this. And the forces of the sequence was there, God, master of the forces of nature, who inhabited the rocky mountain and the far north, in which was continually identified with normal phenomena. The goddess Astartes, in Hebrew, Astartes. Hear that? And Anak symbolizes the cult of fertility and were worshipped with sexual practices. So you're like Easter is pagan. It is running. These are archaeologists, and they're telling you that this stuff is pagan. This is why the Lord is saying, don't look up to the heavens, don't look at them damn women gods, and the fertility goddesses, and Easter come from these same orchards. So what did God tell our people in the Bible? This is what he told us. Look at this. Go down to 1 Corinthians 10 and 20. Let's go to 1 Corinthians 10 and 20. They told us about this. They said, look, don't get into these idol worshipers of these heathens. Don't we got our people doing that today? Oh, Easter's coming. What they got to do with your shop? Tell you the Bible, Passover. Let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 10. And we're going to start at verse 20. Listen to this, people. It says, but I say that the things which the Gentiles, y'all hear that? Your word, halakha in Hebrew, means non-Israelite people, which are the Gentiles. This worship of the Astartes came from the Hamitic people called Canaan. And it was spread over there in certain areas of Babylon and over there in the land of Mesopotamia through Nana and all the rest of that garbage you were doing over there. See what it says here? They sacrificed the devils and not Yahweh. You hear that? Biblical proof that the nations worship doves. So Paul said this, and I would not that you should have fellowship with doves. Do not go to their churches. Don't acknowledge Easter. Don't get into the zodiac, fellas. Don't get into other brothers saying God. Stop using that word God, because when you say God, you're talking about the gods of the nations. You say, Yahweh, or Yahweh, I am that I am. When you say God. Okay? And it says this. You cannot drink the cup of the Lord, meaning into the Bible and in the law, in the Mashasha, in the heritage of Israel, and the cup of devils, meaning you cannot mix the Lord. Will be on this path to New Jerusalem or the path to Wawa Hell? Which one are you going to get on? Right? See what it says here? You cannot be a partaker of the Lord's table and the table of devils. Do we provoke the Lord to jealousy? Don't do that. Are we stronger than he? How many people proving themselves that they're not stronger than the Most High? Look at our people, man. Look at our people. Look what happened to us. Because we forsook these commandments and laws and advice. We went down into this degenerate state. And we want to come out of here, man. So don't follow the Gentile nations. Keep the Most High commandments. What the Most High want us to do? spreading the word, keep doing the work, so you can get your crowd.